All aboard, who's coming aboard? Welcome back into the zone. Today, we invite you to join us on the SS Friday Zone as we explore the open waters.
During today's show, we are going to investigate all different kinds of boats. Now, here are some hints. Some of them are powered by the wind, some are even radio controlled, and some are powered by science.
Whether you're a fan of sailboats, speedboats, tugboats, trawlers, or cabin cruisers, the Indianapolis Admiral Model Ship and Boat Club has something for you. Now, we wanted to see some of these boats up close and personal, so joining us in the zone are members of the club, Scott Black and his two children, Kyle and Elise. Welcome, everybody. Thanks for coming
on. Hi, guys.
Thank you for being here. Now, as I walk across this entire table of model boats, tell us how you all got started in your club.
You want me to go first?
Yeah.
I started first. They weren't born yet.
Okay.
I went to a regatta that the admirals were holding where they were running radio control sailboats. And I had flown radio control airplanes for a lot of years, but I'd never done boats before, and it looked like a lot of fun. So.
Well, we had some radio controlled airplanes in the show last week. And so this week we're learning about boats. Now, tell us a little bit about what it takes to make these boats work.
Well, it's actually not that hard with the slow ones, but when you get with the faster ones, that starts to take a whole lot
of skill. So are these slower boats then that you have right here?
Yeah, these are
How fast do these usually go, these boats that you have set up?
Well, probably walking speed.
Okay.
You wouldn't have to run to keep up with these.
Oh, okay, but, I got it. Yeah. So then how fast can some of these boats get up to?
Actually, the fastest boat here, believe it or not, is that sailboat.
This purple one down
here? The purple sailboat.
Oh, wow. I would think that would be a lot slower for some
reason. So would I.
You would, but with a 10 or 15 mile an hour wind, it goes probably 10 miles an hour. So
I know you mentioned earlier there are some other boats that can go up to, what, 60 miles an hour?
Yes, there's some boats that are actually electric powered and glow engine powered that can do an actual 50 or 60 miles an hour.
Wow.
So what propels these boats?
These boats are propelled with electricity.
Okay.
Our club has decided to only do air powered or electric powered boats. Boats that have glow engines in them make a lot of noise and can leave oil slicks on the water, so we do that a lot.
So you're environmentally friendly?
Exactly.
That's very nice.
These boats are all powered with just a 7.2-volt battery pack.
Cool.
And don't even have to be that high powered. And you can see on the inside of the boat if the camera can get in there.
Oh, wow.
This is all the stuff that happens inside, which includes an electric motor.
Okay.
And then this is a radio control unit. This is called a servo. I don't know if you can see in there or not, but that's all powered by electricity.
Now, did you build this boat?
I did. This is built from a kit made by Midwest Products. It's called a Liberty Tug. And these little figure guys actually came from the Avatar movie. But they were the right scale, so.
Well, these look very appeasing to the eyes. Now, Elise, can you tell us which boat is your favorite?
I like that boat.
Oh, the colorful
one.
What
kind of boat is that? That's totally different from all the rest.
It's an airboat.
It's an airboat, okay. So does this have a battery in it?
It does. It's got a battery that powers the radio control system, and then it has a separate battery that powers the electric motor with the propeller on it.
Okay. Now, where would you guys actually be able to play with these, like in the water? Do you put these in your bathtub, or do you actually get to put it in
Well, actually,
real water?
We test them in the bathtub quite often, make sure that they hold water. So my wife loves that. But we generally have, we always ask permission to run. Our favorite place to run is in Carmel. There's a big reflecting pond at City Center. Hmm. But we also run downtown behind the Indiana State Museum. We've run there.
In the canal?
In the canal, yeah.
Okay.
And we like to go all over the place. We've got a regatta coming up in May, on May 14th in Avon. There's a big 7-acre lake behind Town Hall. And those sailboats that you see over there will have probably 20 or 30 of those racing that day.
Yeah. So are those, do you have regattas where specific boats are entered in those, so you would use this specific sailboat?
We have all types of boats in the Admirals. We've got what we call scale boats, which is what these represent. Uh-huh. The airboat is really just a fun boat. We
also
do sailing.
Uh-huh.
But then we have submarines, which are fun to watch, even though they disappear occasionally.
Right.
And we also do fast electric boats as well. So.
I noticed you've got Kermit working this boat over here. What's the backstory over here?
Well, that's called a dinghy, and actually most of them don't have a sail. But that's a boat that I had always wanted to build. I bought a set of plans for it back in 1970 something, and finally started building it this winter. He's not quite done yet. The radio control system's not in there, but when he is, his little hand will control the rudder, and it should be fun out on the water.
Wow. That's awesome. So how do other people get involved in such a great hobby?
Well, there's lots of different ways that you can find out about hobbies. Most towns have a local hobby shop that you can go to. I would recommend that first and foremost. The Admirals has a website. It's Indianapolis. It's IndyAdmirals.org.
Okay.
If you're interested in boats or cars or planes or model railroads, you can go to a website called IndyHobbies.com. And Indy Hobbies is a nonprofit site. It's designed just to be kind of a launching platform. If you're interested in any kind of hobby, you can go there. And Indy Hobbies will send you into boats or trains or planes or anything else that you're interested in.
Now, Kyle, you were telling me that people that are involved in this hobby, when they join the club, they actually don't have to have their own boat, do they? Why is that?
Because we do have some club boats where you, at some of our events, you can come in, be on them, and try them out, and then that helps you make a decision on whether you want to buy a boat or not.
Okay, so you actually get to share yours, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Which one is your favorite?
This one over here is mine that I got for my birthday.
Now, while you can experience the open seas on top of the water in a boat, the Friday Zone field crew and a special Friday Zone reporter, Keaton, wanted to experience the waters below the boat. So they traveled to the Newport Aquarium in Newport, Kentucky to see what is swimming, floating, and crawling in this Friday Zone field trip.